Hi, so welcome to class three, the painting stage. I'm Allison O'Donohue, and I'm excited about this painting. So we've worked on the birds, I've worked on my birds, you've worked on your birds, making them individuals and interesting, exciting to paint. So I've got my paints here. I've changed one color. I decided on a paler pink instead of the darker pink because the washes will show up better. And I have my brushes, sable brushes that are round, and they come to a pretty nice point. To me, that's important. And they are they're smooth, and they work nicely on a smooth board. This is a flat that is not sable, it's synthetic, and I might or might not use it, I'm not sure. I have water, I have paper towels. That's for washing my brushes after rinsing them, or dabbing them after rinsing them. And my palettes, which are plates. I love these. And water to spray my paint. Since I use open containers, I have to frequently spray. Water for rinsing brushes, and hair dryer for drying quicker between layers. I mean, between shapes. So anyway, let's get started. This is gonna be fun. I'm gonna start with I'll choose a bird and start with a color. Sometimes I'll mix a little bit, but I'm not going to do a lot of mixing. I'm just going to use straight colors with just keeping it simple. Straight. So I put a little paint on my palette. And then if I do want to mix, I'm going to use a little of this Titan Buff. It's kind of an off-white, just to knock that turquoise down a little bit, not a lot. I don't know when I learned it, but rolling the brush to kind of load it with paint and then take off paint too. So I do that. It's when I get a Band-Aid or something on my finger, I realize the rolling because it's suddenly difficult. So I don't have a Band-Aid, it's good. So I think I'll put this bird, thinking about the colors, where I want which bird to go. Kind of doesn't matter, but I'm going to put the turquoise bird. They each have a different personality. Thinking about who the turquoise bird is. Oh. I think I'll make this guy up here. The way that I paint, the way that I create line within my shape is by not painting. So I'm going to go around this eye and I guess you won't really notice until I go in with an eye, which I'll do in a different color. And so I'm not really going to follow any particular line. I'm just going to follow the general shape that I drew. However, I think I want it to be a little bit bigger. So it's going to, I made a few changes since our last class. I added another bird. I added some bumpy things on this guy. And I didn't change this one too much, except for his headdress. So you'll see when I get to the wing here. And you know, if a little bit of black is showing through, that's one reason I paint on black. It's because there's a dimension that is created when you paint on black, and there's a little black reveal. That's pretty effective sometimes. So it goes between being solid and being a little bit of reveal of the black. But you'll see as we go along. And you might already know that concept because black velvet painting was all about that. And so this is where I'm going to reveal a line without drawing a line, making the line by not painting there. And if I make if I go outside of what I want it to be, if I make it bigger in some place or smaller or bigger, I mean, then I don't worry because I can go back with the black and cut it in later. That's the nice thing about using a color like black to paint on, is that you can do that. So this bird's going to be solid turquoise, which has been knocked down by a little bit of off-white. There we go. Going up to the tail. And two. And here's where the point comes in nicely, because it can really take a corner. This is where a good brush comes in handy, because it can take a corner and it handles it well. And there we go. Gonna clean that line up. There's some black showing through, I like that. But this is the first layer, so those some of those things won't show as much. Okay, so, oh, the other wing feather, the other wing. And I'm going into some darker that doesn't have as much white, which is fine with me. To give variation is okay. This wing sticking up. The other wing wasn't sticking up as much as this one. Same thing, I'm revealing that line by not painting it. I'm not painting it right up on top of the bird's back. There we go. Now I think that here I'm going to add a little more of that after all, and paint these the same color, at least the beginnings of them. I'm going to paint the beginnings of them that color. Not sure what I'll do with the rest of it. So there's the turquoise on the guy. So, details will come later. Feet come later. This is when I use my paper towels to get all the paint out of the brushes, the bottom of the brush bristles, so that it won't sit in there and affect the next color. Now, choosing a beak color. Or I could go to another bird. I think that this will be the pink bird. Pink, green, yellow. Pink, green, yellow. Red, no, red. Red. I'm going to make this bird the red one. I'm just thinking about how powerful red is and the placement of it. However, I have another concern. This is the ground. I'm going to go ahead and paint the ground. I changed my mind. I'm not going to paint a bird red. The ground's important because it's taking up the whole bottom of the painting, and it's green. I'm going to make it green. So I want it. It's going to affect. It's going to affect the balance of color so much that I'm painting it now, and I'm adding some of this. One reason I'm adding white to the colors is that the washes will show up so well. Water. Mixing a lot because it's a big shape. Then, let's see. Okay, this is pretty straightforward to paint the grounds. Yep. Painting along here is so smooth. The board is so smooth, the brush is so smooth, it's pretty fun. It doesn't have to be this great perfect line, because it's not, there's no reason for that. And some little black mist spots in a subtle way. I really like that. So sometimes I skip it across the surface just to let that happen. Like that. I like that. Not even painting on the line there. That's good. Okay, so here's coming towards the end. I like to allow these little things because they create more texture. And these little black areas. So, let's see. Now I like to see, how does this look with that? There's a time when I do use a cloth. I don't like how much that lifted up. So I'm going to use my cloth, and I like to do this a lot. Wipe it back out, since I don't want it to be like that. That looks good. So, I like to see what's on my palette and make the next decision sometimes. So I'm going to mix these two together because I see these plants here, and I'm just going to make a quick stem for those guys, just to get them decided on what color they are. That's a nice greenish turquoise. It's a very cool color combination. Let's see. So the stems, just a quick stroke, not making sure there's enough paint. Loading the brush so that it can do that kind of thing is something I've learned, to load enough on there so that it can get its way to where you want it to go with paint on it. Okay, there we go. There's one more. That's over here. All right, so those are there. Now, let's see. I'm going to paint part of a bird. I'm going to start on a yellow bird. I keep changing my mind about which bird I want to be yellow. Pink bird, yellow bird. I'm going to put that aside. That paint won't dry out very quickly. I'm going to put that decision aside for now because it'll become clear later. I am deciding to add another red. This one's so bright and it's really nice, but I would like the choice of, they're similar, so they're both red, so it's still the same palette really, except this is a darker, it's cadmium red dark. So I'd really like to make this bird's hat with that red. It's just calling for red for me right now. So this guy has a red hat. There's where the brush's point comes in handy, because you can make a square corner with a nice pointed brush. And simple movements, not labored, just making sure there's enough paint on the brush that it can do what you want it to do. And I went up a little there, so I just keep going with that. And I like that. I think I'm going to... let's see, accessorize that one right away with a little bit of a muted cadmium, which is really neat because it's, instead of turning pink, it turns this really interesting rubber kind of red I really like. So I'm going to go ahead and accessorize by doing, I need water because it's not flowing. I'm trying to create that line between the beak. But if I don't do it, I'm going to come back with some black and add that line later. If I can't get that to appear by avoiding... Oh, I got more white there. So I can also make a beak that's far too large and then carve it off later with black paint. So this is the same color, but this has white in it. That's a neat transition that cadmium makes. This leg, okay, so it's going to have a matching leg color. And then this leg, this one is the other side of his body, so it's gonna come up on the outside of the body. So some basic feet and basic legs on that bird. Okay, that looks good. I think I'm going to paint this guy here white, a color change. And in this color change, I am not leaving a black revealed line, because I think it's within his, within the bird's own body. It's not a separation of body parts, I think. That's, the wing is separate from, but this looks kind of better if it's blended or connected to the other color. And there, it's. And now I have to think about his feet. So, let's see. So I'm balancing color, thinking about where the colors are going. I don't want all the white things up in one corner, all the green things in one area. So I'm gonna take a little yellow and white, put a cute little, and I'm also connecting that. Sometimes I like to just go right in there and put the beak right inside there. And this is one thing where one leg is on the outside of the body, so go right up onto the body like that. This is a there. And the other leg is behind. So that will go, will have a black line, reveal line. There we go. To get opacity with acrylic, sometimes you come back as it dries and give it another shot because acrylic isn't opaque on the first round usually. Most colors are not. So it takes a few. The white is already looking pretty transparent. Some of it's nice, but a certain amount of opacity is important to have a nice solid color. So I go back there. And if I go sloppy, like, oh no, I've slopped over. Like I said before, I can fix that later. If I want to, it might not matter to me. While I'm on this bird, and I go around mixing because I see what I have here and I think, like, well, I want his dye to be yellow, but I think I want it to be a different kind of yellow or maybe even something else. So that's a strange color. I'm not sure about that, but that's what I'm using. And I left that black ring to accentuate the eye. So there, that guy is pretty done except for details. And I kind of like that color I just made that I don't know what to call. Kind of fun, it's fun to make surprise. I mean, all the birds are gonna be a basic color, but they have little mixed areas, maybe little slightly mixed. Okay. So, it's time for you to start painting, and this is your assignment. Paint all the birds. It's pretty basic, solid, simple. Don't think about form as far as shading. Don't think about shading. Just leave them blocky colors. The washes will be a lot more fun if we do that. So, blocky colors. Think about color balance. Not all the one color in one area. Color changes, small color changes within the birds. So enjoy the process. Share it online, and I'm just gonna keep working. Thanks.